welcome to Academy Guys. So this is my 12th video on G+6 RCC building. So this will be an introduction video on your design of foundations. So which foundations will be designing for this typical project. So I'll be doing this foundation design for this G+6, both isolated foundation and deep foundations. So I'll explain the details of the deep foundation, and also I'll start with the design of foundation. So basically, in this lecture, I'll be explaining how to extract the foundation forces and how to deal with those foundation forces, like how we will use those foundation forces. So as I have in my first video, I have explained about the DVR, where we have prepared certain loading combinations. We have prepared the loading combinations for two conditions: one for your structure design, where all the factor loads load combination has been assigned, and then there are certain load combinations where your unfactored loads are taken care, like combinations using unfactored loads. So those were the foundation, those loading combinations were the foundation. So just we'll go back to the the DBR. So let's go back to the DBR. So DBR, we had prepared the DBR where we have two sets of load combinations. So load combinations for foundations, and we have a load combinations for columns. That means we have a load combination of superstructures. So when creating the load combinations, we will just go back to the load combinations, loadings. So if you observe the load combinations, so up to load combinations while designing, we have used auto load combinations. So up to load combination 54, all these load combinations were your design load combination for designing superstructures. After load combination, this 101 is from starting from 101 to the last load combinations, we were doing this foundation forces. So if you see the load combinations of 101, so this is 1 times load 5. So load 5 must be your dead load. Load 6 must be your live load. So 1 times, that is your unfactored. These are unfactored loads. So just let's go back to the DBR. So DBR, this load combinations for foundations, the factor is 1 dead plus live. So we have seen in the loading combinations 1 times dead, 1 times your live load. So let's go back. So similarly, we have to generate all these load combinations for your foundation forces. So like how many you can have n numbers of loading combinations, but it will match that your loading combinations should match with your loading combination for superstructures. Like if you have a loading combination 11 to 54, that means there are around 54 minus 11, so 32 33 load cases for your superstructures. That means you must be having 33 to 32 load combinations for your foundation design, but those combinations should be unfactored. So let's go back to the DBR. So it may be more. There may be possibility that you may design your superstructure for more loading combinations and your foundation for lesser. So there is no compulsion that you should maintain the equilibrium between these two foundation case, these two loading combination cases. You can have similar, or you can have more in foundation, you can have more in superstructures, as per your requirement and as per your codal provision. So if you're designing for whichever code, you have to follow that codal provisions. So you have to just generate those loading combinations. So I've generated 4 loading combinations for 4 loading combination unfactored for your foundation reactions. So you can check all those are multiplied with 1 or lesser than 1, whichever the factor of safety you have provided, like for this earthquake and So if you have load combination dead, live and EQ, then your live and EQ will reduce to 0.8%. Like you had in your loading, your superstructure, it was 1.2%. So it has reduced to 0.8% for your foundation. So 1 times dead load, 0.8 times live load plus 0.8 times EQX. Similar with your wind loading. 1 times dead, 0.8 times L, 0.8 times wind load. So this way you can generate the loading combination. Once you generate the loading combination, because these loading combinations you have to generate while generating the loading combination for superstructure. If you have forgotten there, then you can regenerate the loading combinations and analyze. So just run analysis. So once you click analyze, your model will, your model has been analyzed. Click on go to post processing mode. Done. Once you click on done, this window will open. So in this window you have to select only the unfactored loading combination or the loading combinations which you have assigned for your foundation. So just select those loading combination and just just transfer these loading combination to this side. Click on OK. So you'll be getting the reactions. These reactions will be required. You'll be required to design foundation. So this is the table of your reactions. So you can just click and have a detailed look at the reactions. So if you'll observe point number 43, node number 43. So I'll just minimize this. So this node number 43, which node this is? So let's assume this is node number 77. So we can go back to the this reactions node number. Let's go to the reactions. So this is the reaction table. We have to look at node number 77. So node number 77, we have total 5 loading combinations for your foundations. So for load combination 101, this is the x direction force, this is y dash, that is your vertical load, that is your P for your foundation design. This is your shear, x and z are in the direction of your plan. So these are shear, this is your vertical load, and these are moments along all the three directions. So these reactions you will be required to design your foundation. So load case 101 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, how many load cases are there? You have to design, check your foundation for all the load cases for this particular foundations. So there are two ways. If you can have a critical load node where the maximum reaction is there, you can design your entire foundation with the maximum load. Otherwise you can have the separate foundation design. So like for node 77 you have separate foundation. So let's say F1. For 78 you have different reactions. So let's say F2, then 79 F3, F4. Or you can group your foundations reactions, like similar foundation. Like if you see, it will observe 77, the vertical load is 1055. If you observe 78, it is 1089. So if you observe the reaction, the difference in reaction is not much. So you can group these two, you can also group these two. So you can group these similar where foundation reaction is, the difference between foundation reaction is very less. So you can group those and you can group your foundation and have a similar foundation. Otherwise you have to design each and every foundations as per the reaction. So like if you can group these three as F1, like foundation 1. So in among these three you have to consider the maximum reaction, which is coming on the node having maximum reaction. So maximum reaction, if maximum reaction is on node 79. So 79 would be the critical and the most governing load. So foundation will be designed for your the critical node. So let's assume we are designing for 79. So 17 in the foundation, which have been designed for 79, will be used in 78, will be used in 77. So this way you can group your nodes. So you can do, you can just copy this reaction, you just copy this reaction, and you can just paste in your spreadsheet. You just need to paste. So I'll be explaining this foundation design using spreadsheet. So that's why I'm explaining using spreadsheet. So your reactions are ready. So based on these reactions, your foundation will be designed. So now the question, the main most important question is, which type of foundation is suitable for which type of structure? And so the type of foundation depends mostly upon the type of soil. It also depends upon the type of structures, but the type of a soil is the most governing criteria while selecting the type of foundation. So I've already uploaded a video on this suitability of foundation, where I have explained for different soil property which type of foundation are recommended. So if you want to make very clear regarding your suitability of foundation, you please refer that video. I'll be going very deep into the foundation design, because since I have not uploaded much video on foundation design, so I'll be going very deep into the foundation design. So I'll be explaining the isolated foundation design, and also I'll be explaining a piled foundation design. So these two foundation design for this same project I will be doing. So I have already uploaded a isolated foundation design based on American code ACI 318. So you can refer, that is a very simple problem, so you will get the idea how to design a isolated foundations. I have also uploaded a video on how to design a pile, so you can refer those videos, so that when you are designing your foundation, you will be clear about the design of foundations. So this was regarding how to interpret the foundation reactions, how we will be using these reactions, how we will be grouping these foundations, and how we'll be designing. So foundations, basically we will be designing two types of foundations. This isolated foundations. So isolated foundations are mostly these isolated foundations are shallow foundations. So where your soil quality is very good and the structure is not very heavy. So in those conditions, we'll be using the isolated foundations, where the diameter of this raft depends dimension of this raft depends upon the bearing capacity of soil. That means if your soil has good bearing capacity, then this dia will be less. If the bearing capacity is very bad, then either you have to go for pile foundation or you have to increase the dimension of this raft. It also depends upon the ground water level, where is your ground water. So these parameters need to be kept in mind while designing the foundations. So basically, before designing foundation, you need the soil investigation report. So for any particular design project, the structural consultant need the soil investigation report. So in that soil investigation report, you'll be getting the details of the soil, and also the recommendation regarding the type of foundations. Mostly in the soil investigation report, they recommend the type of foundations. So if they recommend you with this soil property, you should go for pile foundation, then you have to go for pile foundation. If they recommend that with this property, you have to go for isolated pad foundation, so you can go with pad foundation. Or they ask you to go with a raft foundation, so you have to go for group raft foundation with or any specific type of foundation if they recommend, then you have to go as per the recommendation from the soil investigation. So this is a typical isolated foundation, shallow foundation, where the column is continued below the ground level and it is resting on a isolated raft. This is a typical shallow foundation drawing. I'll just show you a typical pile foundation design sketch. So these are the pile foundations where your pile, you have your column will rest up to the pile cap. Pile cap is nothing but the connection between the column, the superstructure and the pile. So mostly we design pile foundation for group of piles like more than one. So more than one is actually advisable. So either you can have a group of piles with two piles, three piles, four piles, six piles. You can have a number of piles. The group of piles can keep on increasing, or it will be as per the structure loading and as per the soil condition. So the pile cap is the main function of the pile cap is to connect the column with the piles in the group piles. So this pile cap will be checked for bending as well as shear, both punching and one and two way shear. So this was regarding the introduction about foundations, how we will be designing a foundation, which types of foundation we will be designing for this particular project, and how to interpret those foundation forces, how we have to assign those loading combinations for foundations. So these forces is horizontal, X and Z are horizontal, Y is vertical, these moments. So these are the reactions for which we'll be designing our foundation. So this lecture I have just explained about the requirement of foundations, how we are going with the foundations, what type of foundations we'll be designing. In my next lecture I'll be starting with isolated foundations, then piled foundations for this series. But I am also preparing a short video, a video explanation on types of pile foundations. So that types of pile foundation, I'll be uploading a general video that will not be included in this series, but just for your information. So this series, this is lecture number 12 regarding the introduction of a foundation for this project. Lecture number 13 and 14 will be your actual design of your shallow foundation and deep foundation. So if you have any doubt, any recommendation regarding the foundation design, please do comment and please clarify your doubts before we conclude this video series. Thank you, have a nice day, take care and goodbye, and please subscribe to our channel and keep sharing our videos. Thank you.